Ready to spin up containers, manage your secrets, and lock down your firewall all without breaking a sweat? Today we'll install Docker, create our environment file, and configure Uncomplicated Firewall so your home server is both powerful and protected. Hey everyone, welcome back to Tenement Tech and our server security series. In the last video, we locked in a static IP. If you missed that video, hit the card above or check the link in the description. I've also put together a GitHub repo with all the files we will need to go through the server security series, including an example environment file that you can use or copy for your own home server as you follow along with this series. Follow the link in the description. Today, we're tackling three critical setup tasks. First, we'll look at Docker installation, so you can run services in containers. Then we'll look at creating our environment file to keep your credentials and secrets neatly organized. And lastly, we'll configure Uncomplicated Firewall with Docker-aware rules to harden your network. By the end, you'll have a container platform ready to go, all of your environment variables in place, and a firewall that knows how to talk to Docker. First, we'll install Docker using their official script. This one-liner brings in Docker's repository, installs the engine, CLI, containerd, compose plugin, and buildx. Then we'll add our user to the Docker group. This ensures we can run Docker commands without needing to use sudo the next time we log in. Now we'll create the environment file Docker will use. We'll fill in the time zone, domain name, email server credentials, and then leave placeholders for our other applications, such as Afilia Keys, CrowdSec, Portainer, and Watchtower. This single file will power our entire Docker Compose stack in upcoming videos. Now let's install Uncomplicated Firewall. We'll allow basic ports such as SSH, HTTP, and HTTPS. Then we'll enable the firewall. Type Y when prompted. Don't worry, we've already allowed SSH, so you won't lock yourself out. Now we need to add the Docker-specific rules to UFW. First, let's make a backup of the after.rules file. Then we'll open the file and append the following. These rules tell Docker to let private range traffic flow, let UFW handle public rules, open web ports, then block any unexpected container ports from the outside. Back out of the after.rules file. Now let's add a couple more rules. Since we've allowed web traffic through to our Docker network, let's ensure only those directed to our reverse proxy will get through. We'll do this for both HTTP and HTTPS using the static IP address of our traffic container, which we'll set up in a future video. Any web traffic trying to access anything else will immediately get dropped. Now let's restart UFW and verify everything has been set properly. You should see allow in for SSH, HTTP, and HTTPS, and your default policy set to deny. I found that sometimes UFW won't apply the changes to the after.rules file until the next reboot. So if you're having issues with changes to UFW, try rebooting. We're going to do that next to ensure all of UFW's rules apply, and so we'll have permissions to use the Docker commands when we log in again. Running all of today's steps, including installing Docker, creating your environment file, and setting up all the rules for Uncomplicated Firewall, can be tedious and error-prone. That's why I created Citadel, my automated server security setup script. It bundles the Docker install, creating your environment file, and configuring UFW all done for you in one combined script. Grab it from the link in the description to save time and avoid typos. Plus, it supports the channel so I can keep delivering these free tutorial videos. Use code Citadel to get 20% off your purchase. Only available until this video tutorial series is over. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. In the next video, we'll set up the Docker socket proxy so your host can be secure in the event that a container on your server has been compromised. And if you haven't seen our last video in this series on setting up a static IP, click here or check the link in the description. I'll see you there.